Let's talk about Sanger, California's knife ordinance. There are a few and this city does have a length law. So let's begin. In article I called an general, there is section 38-14 called weapons, loitering while carrying concealed. It states in part A definitions the following words, terms and phrases, when used in this section, shall have the meanings ascribed to them in this subsection, except where the context clearly indicates a different meaning. In sub section known as dangerous or deadly weapon means, but is not limited to. In subsection 1. Any knife with a blade 3 inches or more in length. In sub section 2. Any spring blade, switch blade or snap blade knife or other similar knife. In subsection 3. Any knife, any blade of which is automatically released by a spring mechanism or other mechanical device. In subsection 4. Any ice pick or similar sharp stabbing tool. In subsection 5. Any straight edge razor or any razor blade fitted to a handle. In subsection 6. Any cutting, stabbing, bludgeoning weapon or device capable of inflicting grievous bodily harm. In subsection B. In public places, it shall be unlawful for any person while carrying concealed upon his person any dangerous or deadly weapon to be in any school building or upon any school grounds, playground or park, to loaf or loiter upon any public street, sidewalk or alley, or to wander about from place to place, with no lawful business thereby to perform, or to hide, lurk or loiter upon or about the premises of another. In subsection C. Fighting, etc. It shall be unlawful for any person who, concealed upon his person or who has in his immediate physical possession any dangerous or deadly weapon to engage in any fight or to participate in any other rough or disorderly conduct upon any public place or way or upon the premises of another. In subsection D, where intoxicating liquors are sold, it shall be unlawful for any person who has concealed upon his person any dangerous or deadly weapon to loiter upon any place where intoxicating liquors are sold or any other place of public resort. In subsection E, tools, etc., excepted the foregoing restriction, shall not be deemed to prohibit the carrying of ordinary tools or equipment carried in good faith for uses of honest work, trade or business or for the purpose of legitimate recreation. That's it for the code. So keep your blade less than 3 inches. No switchblades. Do not loiter or fight while carrying a larger than 3 inches blade. No knives on school grounds. Please note, Penal Code 626.10 restricts knives to less than 2.5 inches on school grounds. Moving on. In the same article, there is section 38-15 called same, sale, possession, etc. of switchblade knives. It states, no person shall sell, offer for sale, expose for sale, keep, carry, possess, loan, transfer or give to any other person, any spring blade, switch blade, snap blade knife, or other similar type knife, or any knife, any blade of which is automatically released by spring mechanism or other mechanical device. That's the end of the code. Simply put, no switch blades. Moving on, same article and section 38-16, called same. Prohibited in city buildings. It states, no person other than a peace officer shall carry or possess on his person any deadly or dangerous weapon, as that term is defined in section 38-14, or any firearm, as that term is defined in Penal Code paragraph 12001 et seq., in any building operated by the city, including but not limited to City Hall, the community center, the senior center, police headquarters, the fire station, the corporation yard buildings, the wastewater treatment plant buildings, and the swimming pool complex buildings. Folding pocket knives having a blade less than 3 inches in length are exempt from the provisions of this section. That's the end of the code. Simply put, sub 3 inch folder okay. All others are no go. Well, that's it for Sanger, California knife ordinances. As always, I am not a lawyer, and these videos are strictly for informational purposes only. If you need real legal advice, please seek out a criminal attorney. Always read and keep a copy of all pertaining knife laws for yourself. Practice stating the codes so that you sound confident and intelligent when doing so. Remember, you are your own best advocate. Stopping the process at the initial contact, it is far better than winning a court case after lots of legal action. Well, bye for now.